a good afternoon, Miss Rosemary.
Good afternoon, Miss Valentine. Okay. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good.
You know that you're both graduates of the program.
Yes, I am. Right. I was her lecturer.
Yes, you were.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Well, I hope that was a positive.
I think it is.
It was, and I think it is.
Yeah.
Okay, so today we just want to look at leadership itself and the role in the organization. How important is it?
Well, first of all, who is a leader? And first of all, leadership is about followership. Eh?
Right.
So sometimes we only think of leadership as the positional leadership. The HR practitioner has to understand all the different types of leadership that creates followership.
Mm-hmm.
So the discussion on leadership can be just focused on positional leadership.
Formal
structured authority. Because
yeah.
many persons in the organization who are not formal and in no
yes.
authority
yes.
can influence the behaviors and responses of your employees.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, HR helps to manage a lot of the reward tools that recognize leadership behaviors and that engages leadership, because sometimes reward leadership we promote. We determine compensation. So we provide a type of leadership. Reverent leadership, referent, not reverent as in the church, is about people looking at you as a leader. And very often we don't recognize how important this is for us as HR practitioners. Because many times we behave in an unethical manner and we go contrary to the behaviors that we require from our employees. And I say that deliberately because we have to recognize HR has a hard role. We represent all employees, but our employees are defined by two distinctions, and I'll use two clear distinctions, management and non-management.
Mm-hmm.
And there are contentious issues sometimes between what each grouping wants. And we have to manage that relationship based on the perception of what people see their role as and what they aspire to. So we have to walk that chalk line to ensure that we do what is right. Okay? Sometimes we find that we tend to lean towards management, and it is not all the time that managers want things done ethically.
Exactly. I was about to ask you that.
Yeah.
How ethics works in our fairly informal setting
yeah.
in the Caribbean.
Yeah.
We have a lot of informality
yeah,
here.
Mm.
So, you know, what does that translate into organizational ethics?
Well, organizational ethics is about understanding the values of the organization and, more importantly, your own values. Because values is a determination as to who comes into the organization. And if you don't find persons who fit the value system in the organization, there are going to be challenges.
Okay.
Now, you're not looking for robots in the organization,
mm-hmm.
and you want challenge, but you must ensure that the environment that you create does not lead to unethical practice and behavior. So when we promote, it must be transparent and people can understand why persons moved in the organization.
Yeah.
It's not about friendship,
yeah, exactly.
It's about performance.
Yeah.
So all of those things must be in the back of the mind of the practitioner. Because I can teach you the text, but the reality of the organization is how do you convert that knowledge into the application
right.
in the organization.
The practice, right.
And that is the challenge.
But in Jamaica, we do still have a lot of nepotism. And it's not even something as in we're relatives, but we could have gone to the same high school, we're in the same Kiwanis club, we, you know, that sort of thing. And that still carries some sway.
That carries a lot of sway in our organization. That's a challenge for you as an HR practitioner. And you have to be prepared that you may be in a standalone position sometimes.
Mm.
And there are two options. You're either going to stay and play the game, or you stay and fight, or should I say three options. Play the game, fight, or you, as was the famous phrase say, you pack your bags and go,
okay.
And you added a fourth. You just fit in because it now becomes a job rather than a value-adding activity. And that whole issue of ethics is something that we are challenged with in our society. And we could sit here all day and talk about the nepotism and the bribery and, you know, the things that people are doing that we know.
That they see in a system that is not efficient,
you have
to try and grease the wheels.
And unfortunately, we see it globally now. And that's the dynamics of HR. Anything that's happening out there in the news, we can pull learning from it. We've just had recent, in terms of industrial relations, we've just had some recent cases that the Privy Council has sent back to the ruling of the Industrial Disputes Tribunal. And clearly there were breaches in decisions that were not properly followed by the legal perspective. And you know, the IDT is a very strong body, and it is now open to all employees. So, and we find that the numbers of persons that are now going to the ministry and the IDT has increased because people are becoming more aware of their rights. So we manage that rights issue as it relates to the behaviors and actions of the employees. So we have to manage that. And if we are not ethical in our own practice, how are we going to
expect the workers to be ethical?
Thank you very much at the end of the day. So one other area, and this is outside of the question, is about the whole issue of analytics. We can no longer go to the table and I feel this and, you know, what I think, and so we now have to have that quantitative perspective. The numbers talk at the table. Our CEOs, our CFOs want to hear HR being able to take the qualitative and quantitative data and use it meaningfully. Nothing is wrong with emotions, but sometimes that really gives you a gut decision, but we can't survive any longer without being able to talk the language of business. And that is one of the key.
And the truth is, with hard data to inform your decisions, that will help them to be more transparent.
Thank you very much.
You know, because if I'm somebody's relative and I'm not performing, the data is there to show it. If we come in and she's doing, but the data is there to show it.
But guess what? We have an ethical practice because I will inflate your rating. And you see, if the HR practitioner doesn't challenge the line manager as to how these ratings, where's the evidence for your rating, then, you know, it's not just about collecting a document and filing it. We have to look at the results of anything that we collect at the end of the day. As simple as it may be, a health report every month from your insurer. It's an indicator as to what's happening in your organization in terms of how people are coping within the organization. Many times we get the report and we file it. We're looking at the bottom line, at the cost, rather than the indicators as to what is creating the cost that we are facing.
Yeah, so as you say, HR is becoming more scientific.